एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड एड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश नेवजाबाई हिटकरनी कॉलेज ब्रह्मपुरी ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ टीचर डे. ही डिड एमए इंग्लिश एंड पीएचडी फ्रॉम आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी एंड नेट क्वालिफाइड इन 2003. ही इज ऑल्सो पीएचडी सुपरवाइजर इन गोंडवाना यूनिवर्सिटी एंड अराउंड 20 रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिकेशंस इन नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल जर्नल. ही हैज वर्क ऑन वेरियस कमिटी मेंबर्स इन यूनिवर्सिटी एंड coordinator of IQAC Nevzabhai Hitkarni College Jammupuri. I welcome you sir on behalf of postgraduate teaching department of English, and now I hand over this tip session to Dr. Shakespeare.
Yeah, Dr. Aslam Sheikh, now it's over to you, please.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah,
it's all yes sir.
Okay, can you hear me, Jawhar sir? Hello.
Greetings. Please comments.
Is my screen visible?
Yeah, it's opening now.
Oh yes sir.
Jawhar sir.
Yes, it is opening.
Is my screen visible?
Vocabulary building tips. Yes. Yeah, it's visible.
What? Why, sir?
Esther, your screen is busy.
He has left the session by mistake.
Yeah.
So let us wait for him to join again. We need to conduct a practice session daily for the speakers.
Yeah. Do you have any backup, sir? Vaibhav, sir?
Backup of his presentation?
Yeah, I had asked him for.
I'm admitting him. Dr. Aslam, please continue.
Okay, sir. Is my screen visible, sir?
Yeah, it's getting visible now.
Yeah.
So make it a full screen.
Can I start?
Make it a full screen. Make it a full screen.
Yeah. Okay. So, am I That's audible, great. Sir? Am I
yes, audible? You are. Yes, you okay. are audible. Go ahead.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Let me first wish you all a very happy Teacher's Day, and extend my congratulations to organizing team under the able leadership of head teacher. Postgraduate Teaching Department of Gondwana University, and this program Know the Age series is certainly going to help you students a lot, because they have tried to familiarize the students with the present age and its challenges. Today, I have been entrusted with the vocabulary building tips. This is my topic. As you all know, that English is a language, international language. It is a language of commerce, trade, education, and everything. And people who are not well versed with it, whether they are hailing from education field, whether they are professionals or the students who are going to make career, who want to make their identity, they cannot do away with it. They need to have mastery over English in all its forms, whether it is a speaking or writing, whether it is listening or the other skill. They have to keep themselves updated with the skills. Then only they can survive in this cutthroat competitive age. And that's why to me it seems that this is a very relevant topic for the series they have selected, Know the Age series. So, dear students, as you all know that English is a lingua franca. It is a medium for everyone to express their views if they interact with somebody who is not from their region, who does not know the language of the region a person is speaking to. So the two people who are hailing from different regions with their respective vernacular languages need to have a medium, a linking language. And English plays a pivotal and important role at this point of time. The better you are in English, the better your communication will be. So it's a linking language. But what happens? What happens when we see that most of the professionals, it is not a question whether you have a poor school background. There are many students who make lame excuses that just because they had poor schooling, they had their schooling and their college in Marathi and Hindi medium or whatever their regional languages for that matter are. So these excuses, these lame excuses are not going to help you any way. The reason is simple. If you see the people even hailing from elite classes, they too find themselves difficult when it comes to present something in English. So it is important equally, not only for those who have a good convent background, but also the people, the students who think that their generation is the first generation learners and they do not have a surrounding to speak, to express themselves, to express their emotions, their feelings, their ideas. Just because of that, lacking that surrounding, they are unable to speak in English. But these are lame excuses. If you live with these excuses, you are not going to do anything in your life. So this vocabulary, which is a collection of words which need to be mastered by each and everyone who is in public sector or private sector, failing to which they will lag behind others. So today I am interested with this vocabulary building. Believe me, students and my dear friends, learning English is an investment which, if done properly, career for you is certain to fetch highly paid jobs for you. If you are not gutsy, if you do not have these skills of English, of course that vocabulary, word power is central to all the skills. whether you are listening, reading or writing center. So I would like to start with this. If you see, there are four skills. There are four skills: speaking, writing, reading and listening. Now just try to introspect. And you will come. Am I audible, sir? Everything is fine?
Everything is fine. Go ahead.
Hello, Vivek, sir.
Ah, everything is fine. Go ahead.
Okay, okay, sir. Thank you, thank you. Okay, okay, sir. Okay. So, if you see the language skills, they can categorized. As far as the vocabulary building is concerned, they can be categorized in two classes. In one class, we will have reading and listening, and the other class, this speaking and writing, which is the most important thing, completely dependent on this reading and skill, because you, and if your reception is in direction properly, then your expression or your production will be with clarity and connection. Between speaking and writing, this class, reading and listening. See, most of us think that the vocabulary building or having a vocabulary means knowing the word. My dear friends, it's not like that. You have only that much of vocabulary which you use. And that's why we classify these four skills into two: speaking and writing, which is productive skill, because you have to remember and speak, because you have to remember and write. You and in that, in speaking is you have to answer, you have to reply, you have to rebut instantly. You do not have time to. As you do while making first draft, second draft, third draft in writing, that kind of when about speaking skill. And that's why the major problem with the students or anybody in our surrounding or in our vicinity is speaking. Then whether it is policy on the part of professional, some tactics or the policies of the company you would like to share with the delegates, at that time he is to satisfy the queries raised by the audience, raised by the delegates there and then. And that's why many a time I have told my own students that it is a chance and not to be prepared. This is the age. Topic says know your age. We have to know our age, because there is no limit for those who have proficient and efficient in these skills, particularly speaking, particularly the skill which make you interactive. Which make you to sell your product, to sell your ideas in the form of concrete or abstract. So this is very important. That's why we have to understand that we have, in terms of the age we are part of, then you have active vocabulary only that which you use in during the speaking or during interaction. All other words which you know, you must have seen, if you read a book of 100 pages, you understand 90% of that. 99% of that. It means your vocabulary is good. That vocabulary, out of that 90% vocabulary, 80% is passive vocabulary. 80% is passive vocabulary. Because while we read, we know and understand what is there in the in those pages in front of us. We recognize, we decode the meaning and receive the knowledge from that text. The same thing happens when we talk about listening. In listening, for example, you just look at 100 words and you know the meaning of all the 100 words. But this is passive. This is passive. And that's why in a storehouse of vocabulary, which is a part of reception, as far as reading and listening skills is concerned, we have to turn it into active vocabulary. And active vocabulary cannot be mastered unless and until it is put to practice. It is put to drill. It is put to some kind of interaction. It is put to some kind of engagement with the people in our surrounding. So this is very important. And that's why when we talk about vocabulary skills, we have to keep in our mind one thing, that if we understand and we know the text, it does not mean that we are the master of those words. We will be master of those words only when those words, with the passage of time, step by step, will be shifted to the active storehouse, active collection of vocabulary. And that's why this shift is very important. This shift is very important. No doubt, intention, students, professionals, they have high intention. They want to speak fluent English. They want to impress people. They want to get their words done in no time. But are not putting their heart and soul into it. They have no other option than extra. They have to take extra efforts. There is no substitute for extra work, hard work. So we have to shift, to transfer the vocabulary which we know when we read and listen to the vocabulary of speaking and writing. And that's why it requires a technique. It requires a practice. It is like this. Let me tell you. I have been watching Sachin Tendulkar playing cricket for many years on the pitch. And I know that this is the straight cut he is having bat. If I bring bat to my house, I know the bat and its function. But the other day, if I am sent to a pitch to play a bowler from Pakistan or Australia, I will be wounded. Similarly, because that batting is a skill. Similarly, if you want to swim, you are reading thousands and thousands of books on the bank of a river without putting your foot into the water, and you just read so many books, you will be a failure. You cannot do anything. Putting what you know, test, putting what you know to practice, very important. If you can do that, of course, it will require a great deal of efforts. It will require a great deal of patience. It is painful because it requires consistency. It requires continuity. In a game or in acquiring any skill, it requires a sufficient time to master. If you just do on a regular basis, you take a number of breaks, and you do it on weekly basis or whatever your whims and imagination. If you do that, you are not going to get, or you are not going to derive benefit out of it. So this is very important to understand that speaking and writing is different skill. Speaking and writing is more active vocabulary. It requires more active because if you are not, you are not in the convert anything at the time of production. Instantly, in a real life-like situation, you will completely fail. That's why let's start shifting the vocabulary we know but cannot express into an active vocabulary. And it will certainly take time. Vocabulary cannot be mastered overnight or in a day or in a month. It will certainly take time. And with the passage of time, it will make you shine step by step. So this shifting will take place through the techniques of building vocabulary. So the important thing is to read and listen. Reading and listening attentively without getting distracted by your surrounding, by any kind of noise, or putting or concentrating completely on whatever you are reading or listening is the prerequisite which can determine or which can ascertain you the success. So first thing you have to do is to read a lot. But while reading or while listening or while watching something, because when we watch, we keep our ears open. So while reading, using your eyes, or while listening, you require other unfortunate part in this lecture, but that is a different thing. Reading and listening, these two are skills. That's why just 10 minutes ago I told you that these reading and skills, if taken properly, if reception is properly in the right direction with planned manner, then only it can produce results. So the first thing you have to decide area of your interest. You read or watch content which is not of your interest, then you are not going to get much out of it. First decide. There are students who everything I come across, it is not like that. You have to decide your area of interest. If you like sports, then go for content related with it. Movies, cricket, entertainment, fashion, fitness. The stories related with the caste of that magazines, on read sports magazine. You can, if you want to develop your vocabulary academically, which requires more endeavors from you. So for that also, you have to select the content. Okay. Nowadays, unfortunately, we are part of the digital world. Everything is ready at the click. Everything. So you are fortunate. You are not the part of or member of that society 20 years ago or 30 years ago. So read a lot. There are so many apps which practice you from reading point of view or development of the reading skill point of view. So many things.
I think we have lost Dr. Aslam due to connectivity issue. Let us wait for a minute or so.
Yes, he's back in.
Dr. Aslam, are you there? Dr. Aslam? Dr. Aslam, are you there?
Yeah, I am here. Can you hear me?
Now we can hear you. Yes, go ahead, please.
Yeah. Thank you. So, what I was saying, that after selecting area of your interest and the sources you have to take the content from, don't run after the meaning while reading. And don't run after the meaning while watching some kind of debate on national television or some kind of movie. Don't do that. What you have to do is that you have to guess the meaning of the difficult word. Whatever fancy word, rare sounding word, or the difficult word you have. The primary level, you do one thing, you just underline it. Guess meaning of that word, putting it into the context, and always try to get an overall meaning of that word in that context. I have given here examples. Maybe some of you meaning of inevitable, but if you see or in impeccable in the seconds, but if you see first, which might be very new to students, let me put it into context. In order to understand this, you do one thing. You can do one thing. You put it into the context and let's read the sentence. He is from cancer. He will die soon. वो कैंसर से उस कैंसर से की बीमारी है, हाँ, और वो जल्दी मर जाएगा. Inevitable. So it is for a die. Death. So inevitable, you can guess the meaning that first thing you can as difficult and raise into good words and bad words. Okay. So you can hear. You will see that the first that cause effect connection you will have to figure out here, cause effect connection, in order to understand the meaning of inevitable. He is suffering from cancer. He will die soon. Usko cancer hai, wo mar jayega. It is essentially inevitable. उसका मरना तय है, तो आपको पढ़ समझ में आ जाएगा ये बड़ी बीमारी है, ये मर जाएगा बोल रहा. तीसरा शब्द जो है, दैट थर्ड वर्ड ऑटोमेटिकली गिव यू द मीनिंग विच विल टेक यू क्लोजर वेरी क्लोजर. इवन इफ दैट मीनिंग कैन नॉट बी द एग्जैक्ट, यू कैन सी, यू कैन कंसल्ट डिक्शनरी लेटर ऑन. ओके, एंड दिस practice will certainly give you a sense of success when you consult a dictionary and you find it makes your reading interesting. You find that whatever you have guessed, jo bhi aapne about that word is the same. You will feel a winner like. You will look at this. We will try to understand the meaning of impeccable. Everybody is impressed. You have made an impeccable speech. Can this word categorized good or bad? Good speech or bad? Generally, you know, it is but obvious that people will be impressed only by a good speech. Except if that sentence is not spoken in an ironical manner. Okay. So we are talking about general statements here. So this impeccable means perfect, beautiful, excellent. So many synonyms you can figure out of that context. So guessing at the beginning level is very important. Okay. So same thing you have to follow. There are so many listening things you have to follow when you listen, when you watch something and listen. Same thing you have to follow. वही चीज आपको यहाँ पर फॉलो करना है लिसनिंग के बाद. कैन डू दैट. Now I was talking about techniques. So first step is read. Read a lot. Reading, guessing meaning of words out of the context. That is the first step. Watching, listening attentively and trying to get meaning out of the conversation of the. So then. Now, I was saying you that you have to shift your passive vocabulary into active vocabulary, which is required for speaking and writing. Now, this is the time you have to take sincere efforts. High intention, you have to require. Next step, in order to increase your word power, increase your vocabulary is record. Most of you may have known that flashcard is one of the techniques used in order to increase vocabulary. What is done? Not necessarily flashcard. There are so many other things. You can write in square shape and you write a word which you do not. Generally, there are three categories of words. Words which we know, that is a part of listening and reading. We know so many words. Then at the time of reading, meaning out of the context, so there are some words about which we are almost sure, not fully sure, but almost sure. And third category, while we read or while we listen, the third category to which the words fall is the category, the word of which we are completely unknown to. So you have to make a shift. You make a three columns. You can do this in Excel sheet as well. There are so many digital notepads, so many notepad apps available for you. You can do this on that as well. This flashcard techniques was the older one. So nowadays you have Android phone, you have smartphones. You can do all these things very easily. So don't overwhelm your mind with 20 to 30 words every day. Don't do that. Just take suitable amount of words. Take 5 to 4 words, 5 to 6 words, 5 to 10 words, maximum 10 words you can take. If it suits you and if you are comfortable and convenient with it. So you do take that. After taking that word, you just categorize that word. Whether you know that word, yeah, you already know. The only thing is that you are unable to put it into practice, and that's why it is lying there as a passive store of outcome. So put that in one column, then the third you don't know. And in the passage of time, after taking that single word, most of the students are unknown. Even if they have learned parts of speech, word family, they are unknown. How to make noun from a verb, how to make adjective and adverb from a verb or verse. They are unknown to this. So the first thing for us you have to do is, after categorizing words, you do one thing there, and then if possible to record, or if you can do some mental activity, you try to make forms of that given other forms. For example, if you come across creative, then see create, creation, and uncreatively other forms of that word. You do that. Second thing, this thing you have to do at the time of record. Okay. So you record this, you write down that this is the word and these are the forms, various forms, these are the word classes of that same word. Second, you do, you see the meaning in dictionary. So this is the second step. Now you do one thing, use in the English dictionary for that. Don't go for English to Hindi dictionary or Hindi to English dictionary, or for that matter, English to any vernacular or regional language dictionary. Don't do that. That is very bad practice. You cannot master English. You can master English only by using it in English way. So definition of a word you write down, consult the dictionary, and the first thing you is to see the phonetic pronunciation. Believe me, barriers in acquisition of language as a second. This is a barrier. I am a Marathi speaking man, I am a Hindi speaking man. In our region, we find these vernacular or regional language speaking people or students, and our organs of speech is so much used to it that we require a great deal of tongue twister practice. Pronunciation is very important, and for that to have, if you speak a word wrongly, it may, and your mind is blocked. You think that your people must be laughing at you. It happens with most of us. So it happens with me as well. Whenever I go for a lecture, I first see whether a new word, pronunciation of that word or not. Because my students will use the pronunciation in the class. So this is the duty of the teacher. There was a Pranjapay sir, perhaps Vivek Joshi sir must have known him. He used to say that the teachers are the shapers of the destiny of the students. They are the shapers, and at the same time, they are the spoilers of the students. They can spoil the life of the student. So wrong pronunciation done by a teacher inside the classroom will teach the same pronunciation to his students. So this is our moral responsibility, and this is the responsibility of everyone to do that. You have to do that. So phonetic transcription, you see it is there in two slashes in the dictionary just after the word, and you can see it is a symbolic language, and people who know the phonetics, they can understand it. So everyone, in fact, it should be taught from the primary level to the students of English Okay, so these you have to do this if possible at this time, and you can have a visual dictionary. That is far better, because when you read that definition of that word, after recording it, you read the definition of word and you see the picture for that word, it would be easier for you to remember. And remembering a word means, and remembering a word and using it at right time means shifting the passive vocabulary into an active vocabulary. Word you have done, forms of words you have done, you have seen the definition of that particular meaning, word, meaning of that particular word. You have seen the phonetic transcription of that word, and now make a couple of sentences. Couple of sentences. This is the last but most important step you have to do while learning a new word. Because words, when are learnt in isolation, cannot be remembered when the time comes. You have to make a couple of sentences. There and then, in your flashcard, you have to do one thing. You have to write impeccable on the one side, and overleaf on the back of it, you write down a long sentence of it. Long sentence of it. So this is the second step. First, you have done read and listen. It is better that you should give practice of listening to your children. This is not the time for us to take practice of listening, but we can, as parents, we can do that. We can read out beautiful stories at the time of sleeping on the part of our kids, and give them a lot of exposure as far as listening practice is concerned. So record, you have done record, and then the third step. Then the third step is revise and review. I have told you, sincere efforts are required, no doubt. You have high intention. You have good intention, you want to improve. You have joined so many spoken English classes. You have paid handsome salary and hard-earned fee from the pocket of your parents, and everything has gone west. So in order to master vocabulary, in order to increase the number of words into your active vocabulary storehouse on your app or in your smartphone or notepad, you have to undergo these third step, which is the most important. Revise and review. Mark my words, even if Sachin Tendulkar, there is nobody who can equal Sachin Tendulkar as far as that record of his, nobody can equal. But he says that if he is out of practice for a month or for a week, he is out of form. It happens with everybody. In fact, Saina Nehwal does the practice every day, 4 hours in the morning and 4 hours in the evening. So there is no substitute to hard work. You have done two things, and you usually do these two things. First thing is done by 100% of people. Reading, listening, and leaving it there and then. By that, they can know and understand the word, but they cannot put it to practice. Speaking and writing is concerned. Speaking comes from speaking, and writing comes from writing. There is no other way. So you do think what you have recorded. In that fashion, I told you, words, meaning of it, definition of it, with some kind of visualization is possible. And then sentences you have made, revise these words you have recorded. And review regularly with consistency after 8 hours. For example, if you have record a word with its definition and two examples of the sentences, you just review it and revise it on regular basis after 8 hours, 24 hours, 3 days, 1 week. In whatever manner it suits you. But you have to take it very seriously, very seriously. If you don't do that, you are not going to master. Many of us are master of 2,000, 3,000 words. In case of native speakers of London, they know 30,000 passive vocabulary. Means they can understand the meaning of part of their passive vocabulary that reading, while reading and while listening, they can understand. But when it comes to use, they cannot similarly, we have mastered 1,000 to 3,000 words. Non-native speakers are English as a first or second language capacity, we have mastered some 1,000 to 3,000 words. But out of these words, say or assume 50% or in some cases 60% and other cases 70% are passive vocabulary. They can know and understand, but they cannot use. And that's why this revision and reviewing is very important after noting down the word with its meaning, definition, and examples. So what you have to do on regular basis, you have to make it a part and parcel of your life. Okay. Test yourself. After 8 hours, then 20 days, 1 week, yourself. You can take the help of your friend. In that way, you will be resourceful for that friend as well. You remember for the mission you have taken, the vocabulary building mission. Okay. Then revise the flashcard, notebook, smartphones in this manner. Okay. You can do that on your own. Then practice sentences. Engage words. After you see that the words which were unknown to you 1 year back or 3 months back are coming out of your mouth spontaneously, naturally. You are not taking extra efforts to remember the words, and that is not quite possible for at the time of speaking. It requires a reaction and responses and feedback then and there. So you have to do this, okay. And then there are some more factors I would like to really take this in the acquisition of second English as a second language. Students need to understand the root words. English words, almost 80% of English words. So that English people have set up colonies across the world, and wherever they went, they pick up their words. So English words are derived from Greek language, Latin language, French language. So these roots have certain meaning. And these roots form, for example, here there is a word jet. This is a Greek root word. It means push, not away, push. It means push. And if you keep in your mind this jet, then you know in means under, inject. To push in, okay, object, or means to push something away from us. Or when you do not like something, object. Your object means you do not accept it, you keep it away from you. You can guess meaning out of this. That's why roots are important. Let me give you one example. For example, this CARD, this word card, it is a and it means heart. It means heart. So cardiologist, a doctor who is a heart specialist, if you know the meaning of card, instantly you can understand. And still seen on the invitation card, we write that we cordially invite you. Cord, again, cord is there. Card or cot. So cot, you will understand that it has to do something with the heart, because you know cot or card means heart. Then you will come to know that tahe dil se, main apne dil se batana chahta. So all these things are important. Then you can go for thesaurus. You can do a lot of mental activity by looking at thesaurus. People, other similar words for a single word. Okay. For example, if you see increase, you will see extend, similar meaning, expand, accelerate, intensify, reinforce. You can do some more activity here. I will say that later on. Let me tell you here right now, you can do these things. When you do one thing, there is a term called collocation. Collocation is such common combination of words which go together. We cannot, there is no, absolutely no rules or for the collocation. It completely depends on the extensive reading, alert and attentive reading. So you will come across died of, exit to. So you will come across phrases, verbal phrases, and you will see that words just go together. And we have absolutely no need of applying any grammatical rules to them. There are so many people who are good speaker, good writer in our surrounding, and they do not know the grammatical rules. And it is just because they are avid reader. It is just because they have put their knowledge to use. So you can most of us spoken English. The third thing is broken. While we read, we glance at a single word. Instead of that, we should see, or we should always to see, if there are two words, three words which form a certain idea, which form certain idea chunks, which form certain collocation, and we try to see three words phrases, collocation as a single, as an entity which is giving single idea, single chunk. So these type of bites to be taken from reading is very important in order to master. Okay. One more thing I would like to tell you. When you categorize the recording of words, new words, unknown words, unfamiliar words, fancy words, rare sounding words, highly academic words, non-academic words, which is used frequently, which are the part of core vocabulary, but we do not know. When you read that, you do one thing. You as a student, you know that there are topics, themes, specific areas out of which, so you can put the words in a topic under a certain theme. For example, technology. You have under that title, you can use this word obsolete, state of art, update, downgrade, cutting edge. You can use that word. Then you can see under that category, you can see what is the forms of it. I mean, which it belongs to. You can see that you can make two sentences out of it, but it will categorizing thematically will help you to, in a simple manner, it will help you to speak without, to speak effortlessly, present yourself on a certain topic. For example, if you have well-versed with the specific list of words under topic technology, on that topic, just there are so many things. School, whenever you go to school, you just do brainstorming and you can record what the words related with school, teacher, school work. I mean, so many things are there. Programs, curricular activities, co-curricular activities. So many words you can put under that theme school. And you can do this and you can increase your vocabulary. So these are some other factors you have to keep in your mind. After learning whatever from the previous slides, these are some of the key takeaways you have to do. Some don'ts and do's you have to follow. Never consult dictionary while reading or listening. Don't interrupt the flow in influx of the ideas. The ideas which are flowing towards you, don't interrupt that. Many a student, in fact, when I was a student, I used to do that. When I was reading something, whenever a word I came across, there and then I stopped and I used to that word in a dictionary. I never tried to get the meaning of that word out of the context which I can get from the previous and the later sentences. So never consult dictionary while reading and listening at the same time. Don't translate. Translating English into English sentences into Hindi, making some Hindi sentences, Marathi sentences, and trying to translate into English and memorizing that, it is not going to help. So memorizing a translation is another important danger, not to fall prey. Then stop memorizing words in isolation. If you take 1,000 words and you just see the meaning, word of that particular meaning, and just confine or limit yourself there and then without seeing that into the context, and context can be provided only when you make sentences out of the word that, and beware of the destruction. You have high level of concentration while reading and watching television or listening something or watching anything from where you can get content. You have to be not too distracted by noise or anything for that matter. Keep with a complete peace of mind, sit with a complete peace of mind and focus. Try to recognize, try to connect, try to gauge the meaning of new words, try to get the context, try to get the what may follow, the first critical idea. Main idea. These are some of the important facts. And the do's you have to do. Aapko karna kya hai? In short, I can conclude my talk by do's. Grasp. keep this acronym into your mind, GRASS. Learn in groups, learn in chunk only, then roots. If possible, because most of the time it takes you away from English language to Greek, French and others. But it is also important, particularly for students belonging to science faculty. Then association you can do, then you can make sentences also. So these are some of the things I wanted to share. These are actually my vocabulary speaking. So that's all for it. Thank you very much for inviting me and considering me to share my views at this portal. I'm really thankful to provide this platform to speakers from this community. It is very important, Vivek sir. You have done a great job. You have given a platform to teachers in our surrounding. Platforms are not generally given to the people who belong to this type of rural areas, remote areas, villages. So this kind of bias may be there. I'm not negating it. Thank you very much for inviting me as a resource person. Thank you.
Yeah. So
if you have some questions, you may ask, sir.
Yes, yes, sure, sir. Actually, it's time for question answers now. But before I proceed with the questions raised by our students, I would like our respected members who have joined us since right from the first day. So I would ask them only first to have their questions raised in case they have. Okay, so anybody of the participants among faculty members who need to ask any question, please ask your questions first before I take the students' questions. I think, there are so many members, faculty members from the Department of English, from various affiliated colleges of the university, but I'm offering an opportunity for them to raise questions if they have. Otherwise, we will proceed with the questions raised by our students. Okay, so no one is having the question as such from among the faculty members for English. Okay, so should we proceed to the questions from students? Joshi sir? Okay, so the question which has been asked, yeah?
I mean, when you are asking about the questions, so there need not be necessarily questions only. If there are any inputs about maybe the topic or maybe the session presented by the speaker, maybe we all are teachers over here, and if we have something to add to what speaker has already said, then that would be also quality addition to the session. So the suggestion and involvement of the faculty members need not necessarily be in the form of question answer only. They can have their views, share their ideas, counter arguments and everything. As Dr. Aslam has said that this is platform for the teachers to share their views and other. And wherever I go, I object to the word remote part, because I believe that geographically we are at the center of the country. So we are the powerhouse of the ideas, we are the powerhouse of the mechanism and all the system. So we need not take backseat unnecessarily. So we have to be in the leader's position. And I'm sure the speakers like Aslam, very fluently and very impressively dealt about very important issues and delicate issues in the skills like reading and vocabulary. Equally, I am aware that the scope that he had of for his session cannot be done. So I'm sure we will have one more or few more sessions on this or allied kind of topics or maybe focus. And I'm sure Dr. Aslam will also come up again with his more ideas and more expertise in the future to come. With this, I also would like to urge the faculty members, because we are trying to contact the faculty members from our side. But I also request them to come up with their ideas about what they would like to speak about, what the topics that they would like to have the here for their students. So that will enrich in both, we both from both the side and mutually. So not, if not here, we can communicate over WhatsApp group or our telephone. So please share your views and ideas about and how you would like your students to get involved in. Maybe kind of activities like lectures and all. So I welcome the suggestion on this issue also. So over to Jaure for next proceeding. You are muted, Dr. Jaure. Kindly unmute yourself, Dr. Jaure.
So totally we have three questions altogether. And one of the questions is how to deal with the spelling errors, because many times they face, according to them, okay, I'm saying on the above, they have certain
now, Reza, speak spelling louder, errors. Speak louder.
Okay, so how to deal with spelling errors in terms of vocabulary? This is the question raised by one of our students. So please answer. How to deal with the spelling errors as far as vocabulary is concerned?
Spelling errors,
yeah.
Spelling errors.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, as far as spelling errors are concerned, the only solution, ready-made solution, which seems to me is that they have to read a lot attentively. That is the solution. Because as far as the spelling rules are concerned, it is so much confusing that it takes a lot of years to master the spelling. Okay, so you have to read a lot. Students' reading is very less. They are so much engrossed and busy nowadays in forwarding message and getting connected with social media, and not for educational purpose. Not from the point of view of developing themselves, but for the sake of entertainment. This is the problem with them. So reading is the only solution.
Yeah.
I hope the answer.
Yeah, they will understand, sir. In the talk itself, there was much information. And next question. Does it help word formation in enriching vocabulary? One student has asked very strong.
Yes, sir. You are absolutely right. It is a part of linguistics. No, there are many categories of words: back formation, coinages, blending. So many things are there. It is a part of this series is Know the Age series, and we have to keep in our mind all categories of audience and spectators. All categories of participants are there. So it is a part of linguistics, whatever you are saying. So accordingly, we can do. There are so many linguistics who have given the rules and regulations of spelling. So we can just consult those books or the literature available on it.
Yeah. And the last question is, often they come across different spellings of the same word, okay? Like COLOR. The guy has asked, the student has asked, he has found many times spellings differently, okay, of the same word. And he has given an example as well, COLOR and COLOUR. So which one has to be considered as the right one? His question.
COLOUR and COLOR, that is the difference between American English and British English, no?
Okay.
In American, they use COLOUR, and in Britain, they use CO in English, COLOUR, and Americans use COLOR.
Yeah. I think the students have been satisfied with your answers, and I think there is no question apart from these three. Okay, I'm checking on the No question at all now, sir. So once again, I ask the participants among faculty members if they have to ask. Please ask.
Vivek sir. Jawre sir.
Yes sir.
हाँ मैं एक स्टूडेंट्स देखो मैंने अपने जो व्यूज या शेयर किया हूँ हमारे बाकी फैकल्टी फ्रैटर्निटी के भी लोग यहाँ पर है लेकिन मैं स्टूडेंट्स को एक बात बोलना चाहूँगा कि मराठी मीडियम हो हिंदी मीडियम हो ये उनका बैरियर्स नहीं रहना चाहिए अगर उनका विलिंगनेस है इफ दे आर वेल डिटरमाइंड एंड दे आर डिवोटेड एंड डेडिकेटेड टू देयर मिशन अगर है और प्रॉपरली एग्जीक्यूट करते हैं जो भी सिंसियर एफर्ट्स के थ्रू वो सीखते हैं तो वो मंजिल को पा सकते हैं इसलिए एक शेयर मैं बोलना चाहूंगा उनके लिए कि मंजिल से आगे बढ़कर मंजिल तलाश कर मिल जाए तुझको तुझको दरिया तो समंदर तलाश कर हर शीशा टूट जाता है पत्थर की चोट से पत्थर ही टूट जाए वो शीशा तलाश कर तो ये एटीट्यूडनल प्रॉब्लम बहुत बड़ा है सर उनको जैसे कल अपने फूल जाने सर जो बता रहे थे मोटिवेशन और एटीट्यूड ये बहुत बड़ी चीज है जब तक वो सेल्फ इंस्पायर्ड और सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड नहीं होते जब तक निगेटिविटी को बाजू में नहीं रखते इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम टू मास्टर दिस वोकैबुलरी स्किल दैट्स ऑल सर थैंक यू
Thank you so much for answering. Yeah, Dr. Joshi has to say something.
Dr. Aslam, you played very right chord at right time. Today we are celebrating Teachers Day, and coincidentally, INET, an Association of English Teachers, where teachers meet, collaborate, and share their expertise and enrich each other. They are having Mushaira for the language teachers. So this is a very novel experiment that we are going to have today. So in the evening, the teachers of English will present their poems dealing with the English language and their experiences in the classroom. So I take this opportunity to welcome you all and I request you to join with the YouTube link I have already shared at different groups. So let us hope that we will have more shairis and shares and poems from English teachers in the evening. Thank you so much.
Yeah, somebody, you know, among our faculty members has put a question here with sir please guide about homonyms okay yes am I audible
yes sir you are audible
yeah one of our members of faculty has put the question in the chat box sir please guide about homonyms so yeah please proceed your voice is not clear sir Please check your mic. Yeah, is it clear? Yeah, he has raised his hand. Okay, I will unmute him. Okay, so that he himself might speak.
understand properly the English novel?
Sir, nothing is audible. Who is speaking and what is speaking? Nothing is audible, sir.
Sir. Yes, I think Chandrakant Ramjake sir has raised the question. Am I right? Okay, sir, please repeat your question.
Sir, I want to ask how to, is there any technique to read the English novel? I'm Naktodi. Naktodi is asking the question, sir.
Yeah. Dr. Kishore,
what
Naktodi
is the question, sir? Will you repeat, sir?
Yeah. Is there any technique as such which enables us to read a novel? He's asking like.
What? Kishore Naktodi is from my college. I am unable to hear him. He is from my college. So what is his question, sir? Can you repeat, Jawara, sir?
The question is there any technique to read novel?
Sir, that is a part of altogether different lecture. As I said earlier, reading skill itself is a skill. At that time also, you have to focus while reading. You have to focus on allocation. You can speed your reading. You need not to glance at a single word at a time. Instead of that, you have to bring a picture of 3 to 4 words. You have to guess what words are to follow. By that, you can increase the speed of your reading. So many, yeah. So that requires a different session, sir.
Yeah, true, sir. Yeah, but we will certainly arrange one another session also for having more deliberations on these areas. Yeah, Kishore, sir, I hope you have got the answer of your question. Kishore, sir?
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Also, sir, you may try, if you have PDF version of novel, you may download from Play Store a PDF reader, okay? That PDF reader will itself read it out rapidly, and you may set the speed of that PDF reader, and you just see the, lines, how it reads, and you may see how it reads. You will actually get the pronunciations as well, and you might boost your speed of reading too. Okay, so this is also another way there with, but hopefully we will arrange one more session on literature and how to study literature, and we will invite the speaker who has been today with us, Dr. Sheikh. Okay, so it's time now to move further. So I would request Dr. Joshi to have a word of thanks for today's session. Dr. Joshi.
Thank you, Dr. Jawara, for inviting.
Hello? Joshi, yeah. Sir, I'm Dr. Kundra.
Hi, Dr. Kundra.
I would like to say something, with your permission.
Go ahead.
Okay, first of all, I would like to congratulate all the organizing team, and I would like to also congratulate Aslam, sir. You guys create wonderful presentation. You students raised few questions, and they have some queries. I would like to add something to that. Their queries. First of all, first students asked that how we can memorize spellings. I have developed one technique. I named it Gauran Pathar. Because we know that the way we spell and the way we pronounce the word in English language is entirely different as far as words are concerned. Gauran Pathar is that, if you want to just, when I was a student, just I could not prefer few feelings of the word. Like lieutenant, colonel. What I have done that, what I did, we have split these words. Suppose we have to memorize the spelling of lieutenant, we can split that word to 3 parts. The spelling is L-I-E, lie, U-T-E, U-T-E, N-A-N-E, notch. Though there is no F in this word. Word pronounced as lieutenant. But for the sake of remembering the spelling of this word, we can split this word like ute nat. In the same way, colonel, there is no R. Colonel, C-O-L-O-N-E-L. This kind of method we can use, but Dr. Sheikh also emphasized that you should pronounce the word very properly. I agree with you. But for the sake of remembering the spelling of words, we can adopt this technique. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Now, is there anyone
among Dr. for your inputs? Now
thank
it's
you,
time
sir.
To propose a vote of thanks. I extend my heartfelt thanks towards Dr. Aslam Sheikh, our dear colleague, friend, and associate professor from Nevzabhai Hitkarani College, Brahmapuri. Thank you very much, sir, for your time and your efforts. Your session was wonderful. And I can see the possibility of more such sessions in this series, dealing and focusing specifically on the vocabulary building. And as Dr. Kondra has also suggested, inputs for the development of vocabulary strategies and techniques. So thank you very much, Dr. Aslam, for your quality time. Also, participants, faculty members, I understand this is Teacher Day and Sunday, but despite these two occasions, there is a great number of teachers concerned about their students and fraternity participating actively in this particular session. I hope that they will continue to support us in coming sessions too. I thank the participants, the students who are participating on multiple platforms. Some of them are on the MS Teams and many of them are on the YouTube. And we have experienced that the number of participants watching this YouTube telecast after this session is more. So I thank them in advance too. I thank the organizer, Zavre sir, for giving me this opportunity to take part in this organization. And with this, I hand over the proceeding to Dr. Zavre again. Thank you very much.
So thank you so much, Dr. Joshi. Now it's time to conclude the program today, but we will be back on another day as well with the schedule of new guests along with new topic. Till then, we will take your leave. And we expect your such participation in the days to come as well. Thank you so much. Thank you. With this, I will.